Hey Raheem, good morning.
Hello, Jordan. I'm just trying to adjust this volume a little bit. Is that good? Yeah. Hey, Jordan.
Hey Raheem, just wondering, obviously Ernest Jones preparing to practice this week after some time away. What do you think is his level of preparedness? Obviously, we don't know his status yet. And do you think you might have to reshuffle your inside linebackers again, including the signal caller again this week?
No, I wouldn't change the signal caller for sure. We're going to go see his status out there and how well he moves and what he can do. I know his preparedness is great because he stays locked in. He stayed within the meeting group with Shula. He stayed within the group with his guys. And he's a serious guy. He's a quarterback-driven kind of guy, like, him and Troy. They're really into the game plans. They're really into what we do. They're really into their own particular growth and development. So I got a lot of confidence in him coming back being ready to go. And I just got to go see him move and see if he can do it physically and see what he can do.
What's his, have you gotten a chance to talk to him? I would imagine his energy is pretty high with the opportunity to possibly come back.
His energy is always pretty high, Jordan. We're talking about a guy who really embraces the game, loves the game. And when he comes in the building, I think all the other guys kind of like it. So when he came into the meet room today and the coaches saw him, I thought it was a pretty cool scene as well.
Cool. Thanks, Raheem.
No problem.
Kevin.
Morning, Raheem. Sean was talking yesterday about the number of members of his staff who are drawing interest for head coaching jobs and saying you guys are able to compartmentalize and do two jobs at once. I imagine that's one of the maybe tests of head coaching organizational skills to be able to do that. But how is it for you?
It's pretty simple for me, Kevin, when it comes to compartmentalizing what I got to get done this week. My number one job right now is to do everything I can to help the Rams go be victorious this week versus a very good opponent. So, that is my singular focus. That is the thing that we worked on all week. We're coming off a short week. We're going into the move. Very excited and ecstatic to be have the opportunity to speak to different people about their opportunities. You never look forward to people getting fired, but it happens in our business. It's a part of what we do. It's a part of our life. It's a part of how we got to be prepared. You spend time in the off season getting prepared for these type of moments. It won't be exactly tailored to that team or particular to that team, but it's really about the person, how you get along with that group, what type of people they're looking for, what type of people they're trying to tag together. You put some of those thoughts together, you get the information you need, but you move on pretty quickly because nobody cares what you're doing on your own personal time. The only thing that's going to matter is what's going to happen when we get out there on Sunday. That's the only thing I care about. Like I told you a bunch of times, I'm always going to be where my feet are. And right now, my feet are right here trying to get a big time win versus a big time program.
What is it about a team, whether it's the Rams or others, that makes its staff especially attractive to other teams? Is it just winning, or is it other things?
I think it's a combination of all the things. Sean says all the time how we compete with our schemes, but we win with our people. And I think the people here are what's a part of us helping us win. Les Frazier, Kevin Dimoff, Tony Pastara, Sean McVay, all the coaching staff, everybody that's been a part of his coaching staff throughout the past since he's been here over the last couple of years, I think is a big part of that. So when you put all those things together and you talk about the culture of the building and you talk about what it takes to win and the things people are looking for, is no better place than to start right here with these guys and what they've been able to do. So it's a credit to Sean McVay. It's a credit to this building. It's a credit to everybody that's been a part of it. Look no further than that.
And then just the last one from me, along those lines, even with your experience in the past, have you gained something as a coach?
Whenever you're around people that I've been fortunate enough to be around, speaking of Kevin, speaking of Les, their group, speaking of our analytics team, Jake Timmy and some of the people that work there, the people in our building that you can take draw off from Reggie Scott, some of those type of things, you continually grow in this business. You see different ways to do things. And it's like, it becomes intriguing. It becomes something that you want to do if you had that opportunity to do it again. So, all those things you grow from, all those opportunities, not just football, just everything about the organization, everything about how it works together, everything, how it goes, being a part of seeing two stadiums built, one being in Atlanta, then coming here and seeing what it looks like when it gets built and trying to develop that atmosphere. Those are all things you take when you're talking about being a head coach. You're talking about being a CEO of a corporation. So you gotta have some knowledge of everything. And fortunately enough here, I'm able to have those things because of my relationship with the people that are in charge.
Thank you.
No problem. All right, guys, I see a couple hands up. Maybe keep it to one question and we can re-raise after just to get everyone in. Rashawn.
Hey, Coach.
Hey, Rashawn.
The first meeting, Brady threw it 55 times, I believe. Is that a recipe that you are hoping to replicate coming up this weekend?
You know, I don't think you hope to do anything versus Tom Brady other than get a win. You know, when we came and played Tom Brady the first time, we got ahead. Our offense got some big plays, some explosive plays. We were able to get some key stops in the beginning of the game. It turned the game to a one-dimensional game. And our whole idea was to force them not to let them beat us fast, make them check the ball down, throw it all over the place, make tackles, get off the game, and get a win. And that's exactly what we did. You know, those things got to change. I just talked about it last week. When you play teams multiple times, you better go back and look at your plan. You better go look at it and what you did. And you really better study and evaluate those things that you did, especially if you thought they were well, and especially if that coach tells you at the end of the game, good job. And Byron Leftwich definitely came to me and told us good job. And Tom shook everybody's hand. I'm sure he said the same thing. And I know they're waiting for this opportunity. You know, I watched enough of this this man in the arena to know he's coming and we're going to be ready.
Thank you.
Hey, Raheem, how did Eric Weddle play? And do you anticipate him playing more or less this week, depending on Taylor Rapp's status?
You know, we'll see what Taylor is. And Eric did a great job for us, man. His communication, his movement, his ability to go out there and really play extended a period of time. I believe it was 20 or so snaps, but I'm not sure the exact number. But to be able to get him out there, to move around, the communication that he brought to the table, the confidence that he brought Burgess, the way that he was able to talk with Nick Scott and watching those guys really play fast. And then to be able to be smart and get him out of the game when it was out of hand, to be able to use him, to be able to have him for this week. I anticipate his role being somewhere near the same, if not a little more. But we're going to take Eric as long as he can take it because he's a great person to be around. He does nothing but bring us confidence, and he does nothing but bring us greatness.
Kurt.
Hey, Raheem, as long as you've coached, when you look at how well Sean has done on road games and East Coast games, are you seeing something different? What would you put your thumbprint on that?
You know, Kurt, that's funny, man. I was just talking about this. I love our travel schedule. I love what we do. We get in the same time, no matter where we're going. We have the same amount of time to get to our meeting room. We have the same amount of time to go to our meeting room. We got the same amount of time to meet. We go through our same process with our special teams meeting, with our offensive, defensive meetings, with our head coaches meeting. And then we get a chance to go to your rooms. We wake up and it's time to go. And we get on the plane, we come right back home, we start our job and do it all over again. And the way he moves and the way he likes to move is something that I really love and something that I admire. I'm not sure who exactly I was just talking to about, but it's definitely something that's been on my mind and how we move and how we travel. How Sean is able to change up our schedule every week based on where we're going to make sure when we land is very similar. And you guys know how we do that. Sometimes there's walkthroughs, sometimes there's not. And sometimes we're able to go to the team hotel and meet, and sometimes we're not. But I think all those things are a big part of what he's done to make this team to be able to bounce around and just feel like, you know, nothing's really going to bother him when it comes to scheduling, when it comes to short weeks, long weeks, doesn't really matter. Whatever the case may be, we're ready to deal.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
No problem.
Garrett.
Hey, Raheem, I'm going to go 1.5 questions here. have you interviewed with the, 2.5. Have you interviewed with the Vikings yet? And if so, how did that go? And in terms of the facing Brady, Mike Evans, and those tight ends, how does Jalen fit into this scheme?
You know, I give you the quick answer on the first one is no. That hasn't happened yet. You know, that meeting is planned, and we'll have that when the time is ready for that. As far as Jalen's got a big part of going with Mike Williams. You know, he's going to do some things on Mike Williams. He's going to be able to move around, do something that he's done for us all year. His physicality, the things that he brings to his position, is special. You know, we're talking about a guy who wanted to be all pro at both inside and outside corner. And he says those things for a reason, because he takes big time pride in what he does and how he does it. So he'll move around with Mike a little bit. We better get him off a little bit and do some different things. But certainly his presence should be felt if we plan on having any success.
Thank you.
We'll wrap with John.
John Romano. What's going on, man? Who is this guy?
Hey, Raheem. Congratulations on making it this far.
How you doing, man?
I'm doing well, thanks. Very few people are ever in a position to turn down an NFL head coaching job. But considering what the circumstances were in Tampa Bay at that time and how the roster was about to be blown apart, have you ever looked back at that and wondered if you would have been better served if the opportunity hadn't come along?
You know, John, everything I would say after that point, after that question, would be an excuse. My job was to go out there and win football games. We had 1 year we were able to win 10 games, and it wasn't enough. Didn't get us in the playoffs. We were able to start that next year and go 4-2, and then we had a disastrous collapse that that led to my firing. And I got what I deserved. And everybody will get what they deserve in this business. And, like, I think the time and the patience and all those type of things, you can't replicate those type of experiences. So I would never, ever say I didn't love my time in Tampa. You know, Tampa has been considered home for a long time. And I love all the people in Tampa, including their ownership, including a lot of people there that's still in the building, that's a part of that building, that's part of that organization that will be forever. I mean, talking about Derek Brooks and Warren Sapp and Rondé Barber and the legendary people, the John Lynch's and all those type of people that have dealt with that organization. So that time of my life has certainly created what I've been able to come as a man, as a coach, as a father, as everything. So I just think the growth and development, you can't turn down those opportunities for what they were and what they were worth.